after you finally completed the Cuba swim, I was curious, just as a spectator, of how you adjusted to life after the goal that you had worked years and years to achieve. And was it as easy as, I did it, that's over and with, on to the next project? Or did it take some time to be like, well, now what? What comes next?
It's a complex question with a complex answer. And that is, I think every world-class athlete, every who retires, and unlike other professions, you retire when you're young, as a general rule. You know, that's sports. Although I had this resurgence in my 60s, you know, so I wasn't so young when I retired the second time. But there is a drama and a black and white sort of lifestyle to sports. You know it, Diego, from tennis, is that, you know, you don't say, I'm going to be the best investment banker in the world. Who's going to decide that? Whereas if you want to say, I'm going to win Wimbledon, then there we have a very concrete goal in front of us, and we know just what to do to get there, whether you can or not. So I think there's a depression, not only in being the best and being lauded. Michael Phelps has gone through a lot of depression. Well, he's admitted in his chemistry he has depression, but also to be, you can imagine, to be that, the king of the world, and now all of a sudden you're just in the airport with thousands of other people. Nobody really knows who you are. Maybe with him, you know, they do.
A little bit different, yeah.
They do, but as a general rule. So I admit that for 5 years, which is a very long time after someone who's just done a solo event, usually when we see the Phelps of the world, I mean, he's winning, you know, multiple medals over multiple Olympics. This is just epic. Whereas I did hold a number of world records, but to the world at large, I was a sort of a big deal at the end of the Cuba swim in my 60s. And for 5 years after, I was on a rocket. I was doing three speeches a day, flying by helicopter here and there, going international, just, you know, jet setting, telling my story, writing the memoir. People were doing a documentary film. I did an off-Broadway show, which I've always wanted to do, my own act it all out and all that stuff. So I was just on a rocket ship. At the end of 5 years, what you're talking about, Nick, started to settle in. I'm not chasing that dream anymore. I'm not even kind of dealing with the aftermath anymore. I'm on to what's next. What is life? And probably never will I have something that concrete, that dramatic to chase again. But I realized that what was at the bottom of it was the pursuit of my potential. So Diego will tell you that how laughable this could be. But honestly, I started playing tennis at the age of 68. I'm never going to be anywhere in the category, for instance, of Diego's wife, Natalia. I won't be. She's a superstar on the court, and she's nowhere near going to Wimbledon. So there's a big gap between the ceiling of what's great. But I have a sport now. I have a pursuit of a sport. I have a little training center in my garage that's all tennis-oriented. I'm a little slow off the mark, like a lot of swimmers, so I have to make up for that somehow. I play 7 days a week. You know, I just try to learn from all the greats at our club even and watching on television. But I'm so thrilled to be back in the pursuit of my potential at a sport, which is very different than pursuing your potential as a business person. It really is. It has, as I said, a more black and white, defined, you can write down in your notebook, what is it this month I got to improve at? That follow through on the forehand, I've got to get that going. So I think there is a depression and a difficulty when an athlete steps away from their sport. Are they going to feel that talented at anything again? Are they going to feel that passion at anything again? Maybe not, because sport lends itself, you know, to bring out your talents and seeking your passion, you know. But I like to think that everything I do has a bit of a vision and has a largesse to it, you know, that inspires me.